365. My name is Ben Waddell, and I will be your professor for this six-week course. This course focuses on transformation and healing. Now, in the United States today, 25% of the world's prison population is located in our country. Now, with only 5% of the world's population, it is clear that we are over-imprisonating, we're over-incarcerating people in this nation. That is particularly true of minority groups. In the United States today, 1 in 3 African-American males will go to jail, and other minorities are incarcerated at much higher rates in the United States than white majority group members. Now, what we have done traditionally in the United States is approach criminal justice as a punitive system. And so if somebody does something wrong, we send them to jail, and we hope that that time in jail leads them to be able to reflect and somehow rehabilitate themselves and reincorporate themselves into society. What we found through this experiment is it does not work. When you send somebody to jail, their likelihood of going back to jail, so their recidivism rate, is as high as it is staying out of jail. That is, when we look at people over the next 8 years after release, 80% of those individuals, after having been released from prison over 8 years, end up back in the system. And so recidivism rates in the United States are extremely high. Transformation and healing focuses on a restorative justice approach. So restorative justice is the idea that not only do we help right what was wronged, but also we help the individual, both victim and perpetrator, reincorporate themselves into society. Now, as you'll see, this approach, restorative justice, is something that is deeply embedded within our Native communities. It's also something that is spread across Canada and other parts of the United States. And in recent years, restorative justice in the United States has begun to receive federal and state funding. And so there's a wave or a movement towards restorative justice in this country. And that is the good news. As you might notice, the timing couldn't be better. We are living through a pandemic in this country, but we are also living through a racial and class crisis. Now, what do I mean by that? Inequality in this country has been rising in recent decades. In fact, inequality in this country is as high as it has been since 1929. And that is particularly true between white members of the country and minority members. In the United States today, on average, the wealth of a white family is around $140,000. The wealth of a black family is closer to $3,000 or $4,000. And it's about the same for Hispanics. So when we look at those numbers, what we see is a drastic opportunity inequality. That is, the opportunity structures that exist for minorities in this country are much less than the opportunities that exist for white members of this country. And so when we think about restorative justice, we have to think about it within this larger context. So restorative justice is a way of thinking about how to restore both perpetrators and victims into a society after something has taken place, after a crime has taken place. But it's also an opportunity to think about how to restore society, right? And so when we look at the United States criminal justice system, it exists within a larger system that drives major inequalities between groups in this country. And so in order to restore justice, we have to also restore that system. Now in this course, you're going to have the opportunity to read both historically about some of the injustices and the racial and ethnic inequalities that exist in this country, as well as about specific restorative justice practices. My hope is that you read for this class alongside the daily news. You have a unique opportunity to think about restorative justice through the actual lens of a society that is coming to terms with the racial injustice that has always been a part of the society. I can't think of a better time to be taking class on restorative justice in this country or anywhere else in the world. So I hope you take the class material seriously. I hope you dive into it, not for me and not for your grade, but rather for yourself, so that what you do over the next 6 weeks sits with you. It becomes a part of you. It guides you as you move forward into this world as a human being. This class will give you the opportunity to read about restorative justice. We'll be reading about the historic context of racial and ethnic inequality, like I said, but you'll also be reflecting deeply in your reflective journals every single module. And so one of the key components of this course is discussions, but those discussions are rooted in a personal journal. I want you, every single module, to write at least 2 pages of reflection that reflect on what you're reading, what you're seeing in society, and what you're thinking as an individual. Put that on paper, and every single module build on the last reflective journal that you did. Now, part of that reflective journal you'll pull into the discussion boards in Canvas. But the other part, the private parts, I want you to keep to yourself. And at the end of the semester, I'll ask you to turn in your reflective journal. Now, over 15 modules, you'll have about 30 pages of reflection, at least. So I hope that that reflective journal becomes personal for you. It becomes a sort of guiding force for you moving forward out of this class. Again, this course is based on restorative justice. We'll be looking at it through the lens of transformation and healing. I hope that you enjoy the course. I hope that you don't hesitate to reach out to me if you have any questions. I look forward to diving into the discussions with you every single module, and I hope you do too. Thank you.